The aim of today's practical is to study morphological and microscopical characteristics of coriander fruit. For that, boil them.
Hello everyone, today we are going to have demonstration on how to take transverse section of coriander fruits. Coriander fruits, all of you know, it is called as dhani in Marathi, dhaniya in Hindi, so dhanika in Sanskrit. So these are coriander fruits, very very small fruits. Coriander has biological source as it consists of dried ripe fruits of Coriandrum sativum belonging to family Umbelliferae. Okay, so it is a umbelliferous fruits. It belongs to family Umbelliferae. We are going to take transverse section of this coriander fruits. Now, I have this coriander fruit with its petiole in my hand. So, some macroscopic characters. It has brownish yellow color, and the shape of it is very globose or globular. It is very small to handle in our hands. It is a cremocarpous fruits. It is a cremocarpous fruit. That means it will get divided into two equal halves known as mericarps, and two equal halves are joined together with a central core known as carpophore. So the characteristic feature of cremocarpous fruit is mericarps and carpophore. This fruit has primary as well as secondary ridges on its surface, and for taking transverse section you have to cut like this. Okay, you have to take sections, okay, horizontally. This is vertical position, upright portion, and you have to cut like this. Okay, so we are going to start taking transverse section of this coriander fruit. It's very small, so very hard to have hold of it in your hands. You have to just hold them like this, first finger at downward location and the thumb. Hold the fruit properly and pass the razor blade . Hold it properly and pass the razor blade through the coriander fruit. You can get very fine sections out of it. Transfer these sections to watch glass containing water. Have finest among them and after staining with fluoroglycerol and concentrated HCl, you have to observe it under proper microscope. So this is about coriander. What is the biological source of coriander? Coriander consists of dried ripe fruits of Coriandrum sativum belonging to family Umbelliferae. The chemical constituents present in the coriander are coriandrol, D-lanolol, terpenes, fixed oils, proteins, volatile oil, etc. For volatile oils, coriander consists of two big oil glands at the commissural surface known as vitae. Okay, vitae are the specialized glands which store volatile oil in coriander. So as I told, the uses of coriander, it is carminative, aromatic, stimulant and flavoring agent. It is used as spice in various Indian curries, Indian recipes, and so it is very famous herb in India. Okay, so
the microscopy of coriander is explained in two parts. First one is pericarp and second one is seed. Coriander fruits are called as fruits and not the seed because of the presence of pericarp outside the structure of seed. Therefore, the pericarp and seed, these are major parts in the microscopy of coriander fruits. Pericarp consists of epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp as their parts. Epicarp is the single layered, thickened, polygonal tubular cells. Few cells contain calcium oxalate crystals in them. Mesocarp is divided into three layers. Outer layer, it is poorly arranged, tangentially elongated, non-lignified parenchymatous cells. Middle layer, it is fusiform and lignified cells. And inner layer, it is large, irregular, hexagonal, lignified parenchyma. Seed shows presence of testa and endosperm. Testa is single layered and yellowish, and endosperm. Endosperm is thick-walled polygonal cellulosic parenchyma containing fixed oil, aleurone grains and micro calcium oxalate crystals. It also shows presence of raphe and carpophore in the structure